It's your hump day.
Hump day, yeah.
High Noon, Atlanta radio show for the entrepreneurs to the small business owners and nonprofit organizations. Hang out for their opportunity to be on the ledge. Now, let's welcome your host, Carl Callender.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for another episode on the ledge on the Real 1100. Thank you for joining us today. Deshaun, what's going on, my man?
What's up with you, G? How you doing today?
Everything is good. We have a lot to talk about today, man. There's a lot going on in America. There's a lot going on in our community. There's a lot going on, period. I want to do a quick shout out to a lot of people that I want to give praise to, people that have supported me through the storm and keeping my head up, keeping me positive thinking and giving me good vibes every day. And some of these people have also been on the show, but I want to give a shout out to several people. One is going to be James Ballinger with 360 Drone Imaging. He's going to be calling in today halfway through the show. Big up supports for this man. He's been helping me out a lot as we help out each other. We have another person, Yate Thomas, with Kate's Law Firm in Jonesboro, Georgia. Another person that's been helping me out as well as me helping her out. Another person I want to give a shout out to a friend, colleague, Harold Alexander, who's a software developer doing great things here in the Atlanta, Georgia area. Now, I have a couple more people that I want to shout out to, but I'm going to shout out to them a little bit later on in the show. Let's talk about this government lockout here.
Let's talk.
Hey. What day are we in? 19th, 20th day? So I know somewhere in that area. Yep. Okay. Now we have federal employees that are not getting paid.
How they supposed to eat?
How they gonna put food on the table? I mean, for what? For a wall?
That's gonna keep somebody out.
Keep somebody out.
There's other ways to get in.
There's other ways to get in. And then number one, the main thing is, the ones that are you getting out are doing great things here in America. They're an asset to the United States of America. But what you're doing is you're creating a definite recession. I know it's coming. I know it's coming. Income tax. Everybody saying, okay, since the government is shut down, now income tax is going to be delayed. So everybody that's worked hard for 2018 and you're looking for that fat check, it's going to be delayed. That's putting people
in a bind.
In a bind.
Yeah.
Why? The ego?
I would definitely say it like he wanted to flex his muscle. I knew it was, you know what I'm saying? Well, it's been about a good year been in office.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's about time for the flex, flex his ego a little bit.
Don't look for a second term.
Oh,
Trump, don't even look for it. The people that voted for you, don't even look for a second term.
I think the Republicans know they made a mistake.
Well, yeah, but they don't want to admit it.
No, they're not going to admit it. Yeah. No, they're definitely not going to admit it.
Yeah, they sitting there, it's like, man, what have we done? I mean, what have we done here? I mean, how can you sleep at night?
He can. I mean, that power.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Take off that little toupee he wearing. Sit it down on that little mannequin head.
Hey, put that hat on. Make America great again. He fine, man.
He probably sleep in that hat.
Yeah, he probably do.
Oh, my goodness, man.
Well, it didn't make you cringe, don't
I, you know, I'm a veteran, man.
See?
And I know a lot of veterans that when they came out, they went straight to a GS worker.
Mm-hmm.
They're not working right now.
Mm. So they let me know you don't care about your
veteran. Don't care about no one but yourself.
Yeah. And this is what we put in office, y'all.
Yeah, that's what we put in office. Okay. So everybody that voted for that person there, this is what, I'm not going to say that. It's okay.
Yeah.
Everybody makes a mistake every now and then. We're going to recover from this. You know, well, all we got to do is stick together. We're going to recover from this.
Yeah, we definitely do.
Yeah. Yes. I got some. There's a lot of stuff going on in this documentary about R. Kelly. I didn't even look at it.
I ain't watch it either.
I don't like doing things and looking at things that's considered negative.
Yeah.
And a lot of sex trafficking and all that other stuff that's going on in the United States, all over the world, to be honest, and which has been going on for years. And, you know, I don't know too much about the documentary because I did not look at it.
I really didn't. I seen it was a few parents talking about. My thing is this: if you know who R. Kelly is, why would you even put your child in that predicament?
Right. And it's viral on Facebook.
You see what
that's
I'm saying?
I'm so tired of hearing the name R. Kelly.
Be for real.
And I'm just saying this just so I can get out my system, so I can put it out there for everybody. We got to move on.
We do.
You know, his music I heard was spiking and everything like that. Okay. So what? Move on. Don't keep waddling in misery because people like chaos.
Yeah.
We talk more about chaos than positive things that's going on in the world.
I would definitely say, and really what's all in the news is the shutdown and really R. Kelly.
That's why I don't even watch. That's why I don't watch the news, man.
Really.
I mean, if you watch the news, you're going to be depressed. You get off work, you come home, turn on the news,
boom.
6 o'clock news, 5 o'clock news, boom. It's just negativity. Everything negative, 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 negative. Sometimes you got to turn that stuff off. Listen to something inspirational.
Yeah, you got to.
You got your Les Browns out there, Jim Rohn. You got a lot of people out there, motivational people that you can listen to. Go to YouTube.
Yeah, Eric Thomas.
Oh, man, hip-hop preacher Eric Thomas. Oh, yes, I'm sorry, Eric. If you're listening, I'm sorry, my brother. I forgot to mention you. Oh, yes. I mean, even Gary Vee. Yeah.
Anybody inspiration talking about something, not this negative.
Right.
I can't stand people like that.
Right, let's talk about how you get your mind right.
Thank you.
Let's talk about how to, let me talk about my vegans out there. Let me talk about my vegans. Your health is your wealth. And there's a lot of things with the vegans against everybody else that eat meat and everything like that. And I'm practicing. I'm switching over to a vegan diet. Because I could tell when I eat chicken, I get a little sluggish. I don't even eat beef anymore.
Yeah.
But when I eat chicken, man, I don't know what it is about chicken. It's time to take a nap.
I was just going to say, I was just talking to somebody about that. I was just like, tired of eating it.
Yeah. But it tastes good and all that stuff.
Yeah,
but you know, you got that dead flesh that you put it in your body.
Mm-hmm.
It has no life. That's real talk right there.
It is. It makes me about to throw up now.
I don't want you. Don't do that. Don't do that. Ain't nobody in here to clean this up.
But different though, man. We got to find some good food to eat. Like, definitely.
Let me tell you something. And a lot of these grocery stores put on there that everything is, this is organic. Okay,
nah.
You just putting that on there just to jack up the price.
Really?
You know, it ain't organic unless you grow it yourself. I'm just putting it like that. You got to have your own greenhouse, your own farm. And grow it yourself, because you really don't know if it's organic or not. Just know it's vegetables and fruits. But, that's another thing, man. How are you going to have grapes and say it's organic and it has no seed in it?
And we buy it.
Oh, I'm eating some seedless grapes.
You don't even know what it is.
You don't even know what you just said. You eating seedless grapes.
Yeah.
And how did it grow?
See? That's what I'm saying. Like you say, we just gonna have to go back into the old times where we grow our own stuff, and you know what I'm saying? We're
gonna have to get our minds right.
Yeah,
man.
Because whatever they telling us, it ain't right. You know, they just lying to us.
Right.
You can eat this, you're gonna be healthy.
Right.
Then
you be in the hospital. Oh yeah, we're gonna talk a little bit about that health. We're gonna talk about healthcare. I'm gonna break down the difference between non-ACA and Obamacare. The difference between the two. Because I got to put this knowledge out there for everybody. And the corporate insurance that you have out there is definitely considered marketplace insurance, which is Obamacare.
Mm-hmm.
And there's some things the employees don't really understand about that. And I'm going to tell them why that insurance, you're paying higher premiums, because they do not understand really why they're paying that. But I'm just teasing them right now. I'm gonna give you that information a little later on in the show. So what we're gonna do right now, we're gonna take a quick break here, give you a little good music here. And when we come back, my guest should be calling in around that time. If not, we're going to keep it rolling until he does. All right. We're going to take a quick break. You're on a real 1100. You're on a ledge.
We just wanna party.
Slipping up, look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. Don't catch you slipping up. Look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. Look how I'm living up. Police be tripping up. Yeah, this is America. Guns in my area. I got the strap. I gotta carry 'em. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go into this. Yeah, yeah, this is Gorilla. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go get the bag. Yeah, yeah, or I'ma get the pad. Yeah, yeah, I'm so cold like, yeah. Yeah, I'm so dull like, yeah. Woo. We gon' blow like, yeah. Yeah. Slipping up, look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. Don't catch you slipping up. Look what I'm whipping up. Look how I'm geeking up. I'm so fitted. I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty.
Yeah,
I'm on get it. Watch me move. This is Sally. That's a tool.
Yeah,
on my Kodak.
Black.
Know that.
Yeah.
Ooh. Get it.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Work it.
Yeah.
100 bands. Contraband. I got the plug on who a hawker.
Whoa.
They gonna find you like Baka. Blah.
Ooh. America. I just checked my following. Listen. The f*** told me.
This is America. This is America. Yeah. This is America. All right. Thank you for that nice cut there, sir.
Yes.
Man, you know what? I was just looking at some things. I got a couple more people I need to shout out real quick. One of them definitely is going to be Miss Cynthia Harper with C. Harper Enterprise, another person that that spiritually gives me good word every time we talk, always looking out for me. Another young lady, Miss Dr. D. Jones. She's probably one of my first guests on the show back in July of 2018. Definitely a spiritual lady that always looks out for me, always checks on me to see how I'm doing on a spiritual side to make sure I'm good. I want to thank these ladies. Also, you know, I haven't had my son here, man. My son, let me tell you something. It's nothing like having a seed that makes sure that their parents are good. You know, I seen him yesterday, man. We had a little good time there for a couple of hours and stuff. We had to handle some business.
Yeah.
But let me tell you, man, when that time comes for you, sir, when you have that child, you'll understand, man, it's a different world.
Yeah.
It's a different world. And I definitely want to thank my mom. My mom's man, talked with her yesterday for a good little while, and I want to definitely say something for all the ladies out there. Make sure you have some type of male figure in your life that's really looking out for you to make sure you're taken care of. that's going to give you some insight, because I'm so tired of hearing about ladies being taken advantage of by men.
Preach.
It's disgusting. May it be anything from taking their vehicle to a mechanic. And meet these mechanics, knowing that these ladies don't know too much about cars and anything, they're telling them anything. It's ridiculous. My mom spent about extra $95 on her car inspection up in Virginia for no reason. And she told me about it last night. I told my mom, use me, Mom. I'm here for you. You know I know about these cars. Use me. That's why I'm here. Make sure you take advantage of my skill set, because I'm going to make sure you don't get ran over. Deshaun, we have somebody on the line?
Yes, sir. Yes, we do.
Okay, good, good, good. Can you patch them in real quick? Caller, how you doing?
How's it going?
What's going on?
How you doing, Carl?
What's going on, James? How you doing, brother?
And everything is all right. Happy New Year to you and your listeners.
Thank you, thank you. Happy New Year to you. I'm glad you're calling in today, sir. I want you to get your information out, man. I just did a shout out to you earlier in the show, and I thank you for being a close friend of mine, because we always need good people beside us. Not the yes people, to fluff you up or anything like that, but good people that's going to actually look out for your well-being. I appreciate you, sir.
Well, Carl, that's for sure, and likewise, I appreciate you as well. Like I said, we've known each other for a minute now, and it has gone beyond just a business relationship. It has turned into more of a friendship as well, and that's something that's very much appreciated, you know, finding someone to be in your corner, as you stated before. So
definitely, definitely. So tell us about 360 Drone Imaging LLC, sir, because this is a new year, and I want to let everybody know, too, whatever struggles that we went through 2018, and you're still in it, you're still fighting in 2019. 2019 is your year. Trust me, 2019 is your year. And I definitely know that this gentleman, Mr. James here on the line, this is your year, my man. Please, please talk to us about your business.
Oh, for sure, Carl. 360 Drone Imaging, as the name implies, I use drones. But my specialty for using the drones is with real estate, residential and commercial, and also construction. Those entities, those fields have really come along in using drones in recent years here. So what I do is I can go out to a real estate listing, be it the buyer or the seller. I can take aerial photos and or videos of that property as well. The same with construction. That's something that's an industry that's really taken on the drones, because you have a lot of construction companies doing many different projects, different states. Some of them can't be at every single project. So they use drones, or someone locally with a drone who's FAA certified, in which I am, and insured, take those pictures and things of them, of the progression of the construction project.
Nice, nice, nice. So, James, how will we get in touch with you, sir?
And most definitely. Well, there are several ways. You can go to the website, www.360droneimaging.com, or you can always call 678-456-4840. Or you can email me, James Ballinger, Ballenger, at 360droneimaging.com.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so very much for calling in. Now, James, now, you know, spring is coming around, so there's going to be a lot of weddings coming up. Do you do any aerial coverage of weddings if they're going to have an outside one? Or are you open to that, too?
I am open to it. That's not my area of expertise, but I am open to it. That is an area, when you're talking about weddings and things of that nature, one thing I pride myself on is always being upfront with individuals, anyone I do business with. I think honesty is the best policy, and it helps to build that relationship with you and the client. That's not my strong suit. I have people I work with that can help in that regard. Get a nice wedding, everything's up, because the operation of the drone is not an issue.
Hey, James. James, we're breaking up a little bit there, man. last couple of sentences that you just said, unfortunately, we just broke up there. So can you just, the last thing we picked up on is that's not your expertise, but you do have people in that position. And continue from there real quick.
Okay, yeah. From that position, they can help out with life.
Okay.
Right.
Okay. Unfortunately, we're having a little difficulties with James there. But what we'll go ahead and do is I'm just going to just sum it up for him. He's available. Definitely get with him. He's this is his time, his year, and everything like that. Very reputable person. So please reach out to James Ballinger with 360 Drone Imaging LLC. Now, when we come back after this short break, we're going to talk a little bit about the difference between Obamacare and a non-ACA healthcare plan. You're going to be surprised between the difference. I'm about to break it down for you. We'll be right back on the ledge on the Real 1100.
So gone and get to clapping. Go pop it for a plan, pop it for me. Turn around and drop it for a plan, drop it for me. I'll rent a beach house in Miami. Wake up with no jammies. Lobster tail for dinner. Julio served that scampi. You got it if you want it. Got it if you want it. Said you got it if you want it. Take my wallet if you want it now. Jump in the Cadillac.
Girl, let's put some miles on it.
Anything you want.
Just to put a smile on it.
You deserve it, baby. You deserve it all. For you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Sex by the fire at night. Silk sheets and diamonds all white. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. I'm talking trips to Puerto Rico. Say the word and we go. You can be my flica. Girl, I'll be a flico mama. Promise that I can't keep. I promise that your smile ain't gonna never leave. Shopping sprees in Paris. Everything 24 carats. Take a look in that mirror. Now tell me who's the fairest. Is it you?
Is it you?
Is it me?
Is it me?
Say it's us.
Say it's us.
And I'll agree, baby. Jump in the Cadillac.
Girl, let's put some miles on it.
Anything you want.
Just to put a smile on it.
You deserve it, baby. You deserve it all. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Sex by the fire at night. Silk sheets and diamonds all white. Lucky for you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you.
Yes, yes, we're back. We're back. Mr. Bruno Mars. Hey, when is he coming in? He coming to Atlanta, right?
Yeah, February 6th, if I'm not mistaken. State Farm Arena.
State Farm Arena. Bruno Mars. I just did a promo for you, Bruno. Come see me, baby. I need some tickets. I'll take 2 tickets, Bruno, please.
Until I take some, too. I ain't gonna
tell
like
you.
That.
Well, okay. Well, he's a very good performer. Matter of fact, let's make that 5 tickets, Bruno. All right. Come look at me on the ledge, Carl Calendar, on the Real 1100. If not, I'm gonna come to you. I'm gonna go get on your Instagram page and send you a DM.
Yeah.
All right, everybody. Hey, I got 2 more shout outs to do real quick, and we're going to jump into the difference between the healthcare plans. 2 shout outs. First one is going to be for my man, Red. He's like a brother from another mother. We've been knowing each other since 1994, 95. So we go way back. We seen each other children grow up. Always. Now, you talking about a non-yes man? Man, sometimes I be like, man, sometimes I don't even want to talk to you, Brad. You be putting it on me real hard.
Yeah.
But he keeps it real. And that's why I talk to him. That's why we real with each other. Another one is definitely Mr. Alvin Watson for the old-fashioned health network here on the Real 1100. Alvin has done so much for me, especially considering radio and giving me this opportunity to speak and get my information out to everybody out there in the world through radio. And with him and his nonprofit organizations that he has going, especially Kids or Chefs, he is a good person. Good person.
Yeah, shout out to Al.
Shout out to Al. Definitely. All right, y'all. Let's talk about this healthcare thing real quick before we leave today. Got a couple of minutes here. A lot of people don't understand with the Obamacare and the marketplace insurance. That insurance are for people that have pre-existing conditions, the ones that aren't totally healthy, that may have some conditions dealing with cancer or dealing with strokes or some type of heart disease, HIV, diabetes, in that area there. And the reason why your premiums are high is because y'all are sharing the premiums.
We sharing them?
You're sharing. It's not like the non-ACA, meaning the non-Obama health plans, you have more flexibility. It's more for the healthy people like yourself, Deshaun. If you don't really have any type of health elements, then you shouldn't even be on Obamacare, because those plans are mostly being shared by everybody on the plan. And if you have any type of health issues, of course, you consider, quote unquote, a liability. Of course, your rates are going to be higher.
I know exactly. Okay.
Right. Your rates are going to be higher. So with the non-ACA type health plans, you're going to at least be paying 25 to 50% cheaper than what you would be paying on these Obamacare. If you're healthy, why would you be on Obamacare? There's no need for you to be on there. There's no reason for you to be paying these high premiums because you're in good health. You're probably only going to go to the doctor maybe once or twice a year, and that once a year is probably for your annual physical for the ladies and for the guys. But other than that, what else? Why are you going to the doctor?
True.
So why are you going to be paying $400, $500, $600? If you're a family, $1,500 a month for health care. If you're a healthy family, there's some plans out there for a healthy family, meaning a husband, wife, one kid, two kids, that you possibly be paying about $400 for instead of paying
$1,400.
But you know what? When you do open enrollment, you're kind of sort of locked in. You won't be able to do anything until next open enrollment. And this is another kicker. Your job, and you got your plan through your job, and you're paying from your payroll. They know this.
Oh yeah,
they know this. They're not going to put you on a plan that's considered for the non-healthy. I mean, for the healthy people. They just going to put you on a plan that everybody else is doing. Okay, but they control that plan. Mm-hmm. See, they'll let you know. Okay, this is what you got. And this is what we're offering. Mm-hmm. You can take it or leave it. But they got people so scared that they don't know what else is out there. They're like, well, shoot, I work for this big company, this big Fortune 500 company. I got one of the best plans out
there.
Yeah,
really? I remember we had a whole meeting. They came in, this went down, blah, 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 blah. Yeah.
And they make you think, oh, yeah, this plan is the best plan. Yeah,
really?
They don't get no better because you're in a Fortune 500 company. But you don't know unless you go out there and shop. Don't go by what people tell you.
You got to do your research.
Do your own research. All right. We're pretty much out of time today. I'd like to thank you for joining us on The Ledge. And Deshaun, thank you, sir.
Man, most definitely.
All right. We got to do this again next week. I'm going to find something else to talk about. I like this show pretty much today. I didn't know what I was going to talk about yesterday. But, you know, you just got to go off of what you feel in your gut.
Go with the flow.
Go with the flow. All right. Thank you, everybody, for joining us today. You've been on The Ledge on The Real 1100. And bless you and make today a great day. See you later.
And boom, there it is. Thank you for listening to On The Ledge with Carl Callender. Don't fall off. Be sure to come back next week. See you then.
Thank you for listening to another Old Fashioned Health Network show on The Real 1100.